At a party, Karen ate one-fourth of the cake, and Jerome ate three-fifths of the cake. We're asked what fraction of the cake was eaten, and what fraction of the cake is left. We'll solve this problem two ways. We'll first solve it by modeling the fractions using these rectangles that represent one cake, and then we'll come back and solve it using a common denominator. So we're first going to use this rectangle to model how much of the cake Karen ate. Then we'll use this rectangle to represent how much Jerome ate. Notice that Karen ate one-fourth of the cake, which means she ate one piece the size of one-fourth of the cake. So because the denominator here is 4, we cut or partition the cake into 4 equal pieces, in this case horizontally, and because Karen ate one-fourth of the cake, she ate this much of the cake. Now because Jerome ate pieces of different size, he ate 3 pieces the size of one-fifth. To model how much he ate, we'll cut or divide the rectangle into 5 equal pieces vertically, as shown here. So because Jerome ate 3/5 of the cake, he ate 1/5, 2/5, and 3/5 of the cake. Now if we want to know how much of the cake is left, we have to cut the cake into pieces of the same size. So notice how if we take the cake, divide it horizontally into 4 equal pieces or partitions, and then vertically into 5 equal pieces or partitions, the cake would look like this, where now we have 20 pieces of the same size. And now if we do the same for Karen's model and Jerome's model, we should be able to figure out how much of the cake was eaten and how much is left. So we'll divide this into 5 equal partitions vertically. And we'll divide this into 4 equal partitions horizontally. Notice by doing this, we now know that Karen ate 1/4 of the cake, which is also equivalent to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 20ths of the cake. And we now know that Jerome ate 3/5 of the cake, which is equivalent to 4, 8, 12 20ths. And now in this cake, we'll model how much of the cake was eaten. So again, Karen ate 5 20ths. So she ate this much, and Jerome ate 12 20ths, so we have 3 20ths, 6 20ths, 9 20ths, and 12 20ths. So notice how a total of 17 20ths was eaten, which is the answer to the first question. And what fraction of the cake is left? We can see 3 20ths is left. So here's how we can solve this problem using modeling, but now let's solve it again by using common denominators. If we want to know what fraction of the cake was eaten, and Karen ate 1/4 of the cake, and Jerome ate 3/5 of the cake, we can just add the two fractions to determine what fraction of the cake was eaten. So for 1/4 plus 3/5, we do have to obtain a common denominator, which is the least common multiple of 4 and 5, which would be 20. So to write the equivalent fraction for 1/4 with a denominator of 20, we multiply by 5 over 5. To write the equivalent fraction to 3/5 with a denominator of 20, we multiply by 4 over 4. So this gives us 5 20ths plus 12 20ths, which equals 17 20ths, as we had before. So now we know by obtaining a common denominator in this case, we're cutting the cake into pieces of the same size so we know exactly how much Karen ate and how much Jerome ate. Now for part B, to determine what fraction of the cake is left, we'd have the entire cake, which is 1, minus the fraction eaten, which is 17 20ths. Well, we can write 1 as 1 over 1, and then minus 17 20ths. Notice here our common denominator would be 20. We'd multiply 1 over 1 by 20 over 20. So we have 20 20ths minus 17 20ths, which equals 3 20ths. So 3 20ths of the cake is left. I hope you found this helpful.